Hello everyone, welcome to Principles of Communication System lecture series.
In this lecture video, we are going to discuss about generation of FM signal by using Hartley oscillator, voltage control oscillator and frequency stabilization. There are essentially two basic methods of generating the frequency modulated wave. They are, the first one is direct method and second one is indirect method. In the direct method of producing FM, the carrier frequency is directly varied according to the incoming message signal or modulating signal. In the indirect method of FM, the modulating signal first produces a narrow band FM wave and subsequently the frequency deviation is increased to the desired value using frequency multiplication techniques. The first we will look into direct method of generating the FM signal. So in this method, frequency modulation is done by using voltage control oscillator. The voltage control oscillator is an oscillator whose frequency can be controlled by external voltage. In a voltage control oscillator, the oscillation voltage changes linearly with control or external voltage. In direct FM generation system, the instantaneous frequency of carrier wave is varied in accordance with the amplitude of the baseband signal MFT by using voltage control oscillator. So usually we design the voltage control oscillator by using resistor, capacitor and inductance, and this is one of the voltage control oscillator. So and we connect it to controlled voltage, and this is the output of the voltage control oscillator. The frequency of the voltage control oscillator is inversely proportional to resistance, capacitance and inductance. So for example, if you design the voltage control oscillator by using resistor and capacitor, the frequency is inversely proportional to root of resistor and capacitance value. So it's equal to F, it's equal to 1 divided by root R into C. So in case of, if you design the oscillator using inductance and capacitance, the frequency F is inversely proportional to root inductance and capacitance. So it's equal to F, it's equal to 1 divided by root L into C. In the direct method of FM generation, the instantaneous frequency of the carrier wave is varied according to the modulating signal by means of a device is called a voltage control oscillator. To produce a FM, we use a circuit that converts a modulating voltage into a corresponding change in the capacitance or inductance to the oscillator tank, as shown in this figure. And this is the Hartley oscillator circuit. It consists of capacitance C of T and inductance L1 and L2 and bipolar junction transistor. The main requirement of the frequency modulator is a variable output frequency with the variation proportional to the instantaneous value of the modulating voltage. The order desirable characters are that the unmodulated frequency should be constant and the frequency deviation produces in independent of the modulating signal frequencies. There are a number of devices whose reactance can be varied by applying of the voltage. The three terminal ones is included the FET and bipolar junction transistor BJT, while two terminal devices is varector diode. So here we use C of T, and three terminal device is BJT. If such a device is placed across the tank circuit of LC oscillator, and this is the tank circuit we design using inductance and capacitance, and this is the tank circuit, and tank is tuned so that when modulating signal is not applied, the oscillator frequency is equal to a desired carrier frequency, then FM will be produced when the reactance of the device is varied by modulating voltage. The larger the amplitude of the modulating voltage, the larger the reactance variation and therefore the frequency deviations. When the modulating voltage is zero, the variable reactance will have its average value. Thus, at the carrier frequency, the oscillator inductance is tuned by its own capacitance in parallel with average reactance to the variable devices. The frequency of the oscillator of the Hartley oscillator is given by F I of t. It's equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root L1 plus L2 into C of t. So Hartley oscillator we design using transistor, inductor and capacitor. The capacitor is C of t, inductance are L1 and L2. So we connected in parallel, and inductance we connected in series. So we know that oscillating frequency F is equal to 1 divided by root L into C. So here we use two inductance we connected in series, and total inductance is equal to L1 plus L2. So it's equal to Fi of t, it's equal to 1 divided by 2 pi into root L1 plus L2 into C of t. And this is the frequency of the Hartley oscillator. So where C of t is the total capacitance of the fixed capacitor and the variable voltage capacitor. So we call it as a C of t. And L1 and L2 are the two inductance in the frequency determining network of the oscillator. And this is L1 and this is L2. Assume that for a sinusoidal modulating wave of the frequency FM and capacitance C of t is expressed as, so C of t is equal to C naught plus delta C. So delta C is the change of capacitance into M of t. So M of t is the message signal. It's equal to cos 2 pi FM into t. So FM is the modulating signal frequency. So where C naught is the total capacitance in absence of modulation, and delta C is the maximum change in capacitance. So this is the delta C is the maximum change in capacitance, and C naught is the total capacitance in the absence of modulation, and FM is the modulating signal frequency. So we know that Fi of t, it's equal to 1 divided by 2 pi into root L1 plus L2 into C of t, and C of t, it's equal to C naught plus delta C into cos 2 pi FM into t. Then, so we have to substitute C of t into Fi of t equation. substitute C of t into Fi of t equation, then you simplify the equation. So after simplification, so we get Fi of t, it's equal to F naught into 1 plus delta C divided by C naught into cos 2 pi Fm into t to the power minus 1 by 2, where F naught is the unmodulated frequency of oscillation, that is F naught is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root C naught into L1 plus L2. So this is the F naught value. It's provided that the maximum change in the capacitance delta C is small compared with the unmodulated capacitance C naught. So we may approximate this equation. So Fi of t is the instantaneous frequency is approximately it's equal to F naught into 1 minus delta C divided by 2 C naught cos 2 pi Fm into t. So just you eliminate to the power minus 1 by 2. So using approximation we can easily eliminate minus 1 by 2 terms. So we get 1 minus delta C divided by 2 into C naught cos 2 pi Fm into t. So this is the approximate equation. Let delta C by 2 C naught it's equal to minus delta F divided by F naught. So F naught is the unmodulated frequency of the oscillator and delta F is the change of frequency. It's exactly it's equal to change of capacitance divided by 2 into C naught. Let us assume delta C divided by 2 C naught it's equal to minus delta F divided by F naught. Hence the instantaneous frequency of the oscillator which is being frequently modulated by varying the capacitance of the frequency determining network is approximately is given by Fi of t it's equal to F naught plus delta F into cos 2 pi Fm into t. So here we assume delta C divided by 2 C naught is equal to minus delta F divided by F naught. So this is the instantaneous frequency equation. Just you replace delta C divided by 2 C naught into minus delta F divided by F naught. So here F naught is common for first term and second term. Then you multiply F naught with 1. So we get F naught into 1 is equal to F naught. This is the first term. And this term it's equal to minus delta F divided by F naught. So and this is the negative sign. So here negative sign we multiply with the negative sign, we get the positive value, and this is the positive sign and the denominator is F naught, and again we numerator F naught we multiply with the second term. So numerator F naught and denominator F naught get cancelled and remaining value is delta F. So this is the delta F and cos 2 pi Fm into t. So cos 2 pi Fm into t is the message signal. The instantaneous frequency Fi of t is approximately it's equal to F naught plus delta F into cos 2 pi Fm into t. The desired relation for the instantaneous frequency of an Fm wave as a summing the sinusoidal modulation. So in voltage controlled oscillator the input is modulating signal, and this is the modulating signal. The voltage controlled oscillator output is frequency modulated wave. So this is the frequency modulated wave. In frequency modulated wave we get the F maximum and F minimum values. The direct method of FM generation is very simple and cheap process, but this method can't be used for broadcast application because the LC oscillator is used in this method is not very stable. In frequency depends upon the various parameters such as a temperature, device aging, etc. So that's why LC oscillator is it's not used in broadcast application. In order to generate a wideband FM wave with a required frequency deviation, we can use this configuration. So this configuration, it consists of voltage control oscillator followed by series of frequency multiplier and mixer. So this is the voltage control oscillator, this is a frequency multiplier and mixer. This configuration permits the attainments of good oscillator stability, constant professionality between the output frequency change and input voltage change, and the necessary frequency deviation to achieve in wideband FM. MFT is the message signal is connected to voltage control oscillator. The main function of the voltage control oscillator is oscillate frequency is controlled by voltage input. So output of the voltage control oscillator is connected to frequency multiplier. The frequency multiplier is an electronic circuit that generates an output frequency is multiple of its input frequency. For example, you take input of the frequency multiplier is 5 kilo 5, and frequency multiplication factor n, it's equal to 5. The output of the frequency multiplier, it's equal to 25. The frequency multiplier output is totally depends on multiplication factor. The output of the frequency multiplier is connected to mixer, and mixer inputs are frequency multiplier output and fixed oscillator output. The main function of the mixer is that creates a new frequency from two applied inputs. So here applied inputs are frequency multiplier and fixed oscillator. So here we get the new frequency output. The output of the mixer is sum or difference of the original frequencies. Output of the mixer again we connected to frequency multiplier, and multiplier output is connected to band pass filter. So band pass filter extract only design frequency. The output of the band pass filter is wide band FM wave. Previous configuration, carrier frequency is not obtained from a highly stable oscillator. In feedback scheme, we have to generate a stable carrier by using crystal oscillator. So frequency stabilized FM and crystal oscillator is applied to a mixer. The mixer output again we apply to frequency discriminator. Frequency discriminator is a device whose output voltage has an instantaneous amplitude that is proportional to the instantaneous frequency of the FM signal is applied to its input, and mixer output is the input of the frequency discriminator. The output of the frequency discriminator is applied to a low pass filter and amplifier. When the FM transmitter has exactly the correct carrier frequency, the low pass filter output is 0. So low pass filter output is 0. However, the deviation of the transmitter carrier frequency from its assigned value will cause the frequency discriminator filter combination to develop a DC output voltage with a polarity determined by the sense of transmitter frequency drift. This DC voltage, after suitable amplification, it applied to a voltage control oscillator of the FM transmitter in such a way as to modify the frequency of the oscillator in a direction that tends to restore a carrier frequency to its correct value. The output of the low pass filter and amplifier is applied to a voltage control oscillator. So output of the voltage control oscillator is the frequency stabilized FM wave, and this again we connected to mixer. So this is the loop circuit.
Thank you.